Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Malik Al-Qudus.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Inna alhamdulillahi nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem. Amma ba'd. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yasir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the universe, and peace and blessing of Allah be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As usual, mashallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has got beautiful names, and you can call upon these names and ask Allah's help, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, today inshallah I'm going to speak about one of the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Al-Hayy. And why this is so important in our life, we have to understand that. First, this word Al-Hayy is mentioned in 5 different places of the Quran, which I'm going to read to you inshallah. And at the same time, I also want to tell you that this Hayy is the only quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is true deity, true divine, through a God who can be worshipped. Because see, today if we see all these different parts in the world, that people have different gods, people have got different deities, people have got different statues and idols that they worship, and all of them have someone as a human being came into their life, lived like a holy person, lived like a divine person with miracles, and after sometimes that has gone, it has died. So now we have to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Hayy. Can Allah be equal to them, or can they be equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No. So let's understand from the verses of the Quran. One place in Surah Al-Baqarah 255, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Allahu la ilaha illahu Al-Hayyu Al-Qayyum, that there is no God to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because He is ever living and He is self-subsisting, eternal. So this is one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one place of the Quran. In another place of the Quran, this is the second place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ. And this is to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he was surrounded by those Meccans who were worshipping Lat, Manat, Uzza, and all those 360 different gods. And they were just people in the history. They have gone, they died, and nobody knows where they are now. So that way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have to put your trust only in the one who is ever living, who never dies. Subhanallah. Wa tawakkal ala al-hayy alladhi la yamut, and you put your trust only upon the one that never dies, who is ever living. And that is in Surah Al-Furqan, verse 58. In another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, it is huwa al-hayyu la ilaha illa hu. It is in Surah Al-Ghafir, chapter 65, verse 65, sorry. It says that He is the living one. There is no God but He. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only deity that to be worshipped, because Allah is not something you can say He came for a certain period and then He died. He is not from, 999 and then He died in 2002 or 2010. No, Allah is ever living. So He is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. Subhanallah. Then we go to the last one, mashallah. There are a few more verses, but alhamdulillah, this is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about that on the day of judgment, people will realize who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But those who have rejected Allah in this dunya and they went after the dead people, they will be, in agony and distress, and they will be upset on the day of judgment. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Taha, verse 111. It says, وَعَنَتِ الْوُجُوهُ لِلْحَيِّ الْقَيُّومِ وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ حَمَلَ ظُلْمًا, that all faces shall be humbled before Him, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the living and the self-subsisting, eternal. Hopeless indeed will be the man that carries iniquity on his back. So this is, my brothers and sisters, I would like to end with this inshallah. And my next video will be about Al-Qayyum. And then inshallah, I will explain to you that what is Hayy and Al-Qayyum in our life today, and what best example that Prophet ﷺ has set up for us. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.